Before starting this course on career counseling, it is extremely important to understand why you should take your career choice seriously. In this video, we will help you understand the importance of making the right career choice for yourself. So, why is your career choice so important? It is important because it determines a lot of things in your life, including number 1. Quality of life. Your career choice plays a huge role in deciding where you live, how flexible your life is, and the kinds of things you are able to do in your free time. Number 2. Identity. Ask any elder person about their career and they will tell you about it as a part of their identity. They'll say something like, "I am a journalist," instead of, "I report news." Notice how everybody asks you, "What do you want to be when you grow up?" and not, "What do you want to do when you grow up?" This shows that your career choice shapes your identity. Number 3. Impact. Every human life touches thousands of other lives in so many different ways. If you select any 60-year-old person who is about to retire, take a time machine, find him as an infant, throw that infant into trash, and then come back to the present day, you'll find that a countless number of things around you have changed. So whatever career you choose, the world will be affected by it. Anything that determines your quality of life, your identity, and the impact that you make should be taken very seriously. And that includes your career choice also. So we hope that this short video could help you understand the importance of making the right career choice. Having done that, we will now move forward to start our career counseling course. We are pretty excited and we hope you are too. So, let's begin. See you.
Good evening, everyone. Welcome to day 29 of Probano's Live Podcast. सबसे पहले सबको स्वागत है. Actually, आज थोड़ा लग रहा होगा बहुत ज़्यादा अपी अपी साउंड कर रहा हूँ क्योंकि आई एम वेरी एक्साइटेड आज के पॉडकास्ट के लिए. फर्स्टली ऑल द ऑडियंस मेम्बर्स, वेलकम टू द स्ट्रीम. आदित्य, मिस्टर सेन, एंड ऑफकोर्स मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंटली मिस अजीज़ा जी, अजीज़ा तियाब जी हैदरी. मैम, अगर आपका मिडिल नेम मैं मिसप्रोनाउंस कर रहा हूँ, प्लीज़ मुझे पनिश मत कीजिए. अजीज़ा जी हैज़ बीन वर्किंग विथ चिल्ड्रेन विथ हियरिंग लॉस सिंस 1970. शी एस्टैब्लिश ऑरेड, ऑरल एजुकेशन फॉर चिल्ड्रेन विथ हियरिंग इम्पेयरमेंट, इन 1986 एंड द ऑरेड चैरिटेबल ट्रस्ट इन 1991. द मेथड यूज्ड एट ऑरेड इज नोन एज द ऑडिटरी वर्बल अप्रोच दैट टीचर्स इवन प्रोफाउंडली डेफ चिल्ड्रेन to listen and speak. It was then the first of its kind. ORED has a wonderful team of therapists and administration staff who take care of almost 1,000 children from over 90 cities and several countries as well. ORED was established so that new technology could be made available to underprivileged children as well. 80% of the children are taught free or pay fees on a sliding scale. We are largely dependent on, ORED is largely dependent on contributions and donations. ORED Hyderabad was established in 2004, which is in capable hands of Kim Chadda, a parent and an ex-student. Aziza ji has developed a tool for the audiological management of cochlear implant recipients known as the Aziza Grid, which has a US patent, has been included in a series of DVDs published in the US, which are being used internationally. She was invited to present at the AG Bell Convention held in the US on 3 occasions. Ma'am, Aziza ma'am, thank you so much for being with us today. It's really an honor to have you with us. You know, you've been working in the industry for over 50 years now. And, you know, I was really excited ki special education ke field mein se koi kisi ko la sake on this podcast. ताकि यू नो वी कैन एक्सप्लोर दिस फील्ड जो कि अभी भी थोड़ा आई वुड से अंडर एक्सप्लोर्ड है इंडियन कम्युनिटीज़ में. सो आई एम रियली एक्साइटेड. मैम थैंक यू सो मच फॉर कमिंग इन. अगर आप इंट्रोड्यूस कर सकते हो इन योर ओन वर्ड्स बिसाइड्स वॉट एवर आई हैव सेड राइट नाउ. ओवर टू यू मैम.
Well, what can I say? I just repeat my name. I'm Aziza. I've been working from the time I was young to the time I've grown old with hearing impaired children. And I'm happy to be here if it helps to make people, young people, decide to go into these kind of fields because it's important. There aren't enough people doing this work.
Right. मैं बता दूँ कि special education, the field that Aziza ji ma'am is working in, that is working with children with hearing impairment. Usually ye main clear kar do ki hearing impairment does not mean being deaf completely. There are different stages hote hain, alag alag level ki severity hote hain, and it comes under the special education or special needs category jo ki which I worked in. So isliye thoda kuch zyada excited lag raha hu. गाइज आपके कोई भी क्वेश्चन होंगे, आपके कोई भी क्वेश्चन कॉमेंट्स बिल्कुल कॉमेंट सेक्शन में लगा दीजिए. विल गेट टू देम वन बाई वन. सो फर्स्टली मैम आई वुड वॉन्ट टू नो कि हाउ डिड यू यू नो गेट इन टू दिस पर्टिकुलर फील्ड दैट टू इन 1970 जब इवन नाउ इट्स स्टिल अंडर डेवलप नॉट अंडर डेवलप अंडर एक्सप्लोर्ड करियर फील्ड. तो बैक देन हाउ डिड यू गेट इन टू दिस, वॉट इंस्पायर यू टू गेट इन टू दिस फील्ड?
Well, it's nothing very exciting. I always loved teaching from the time I was a child. And when I was in boarding school in Dehradun, I was in Wellham, and we had a group teaching all our helpers' children on weekends. And I was part of that, so I enjoyed teaching there as well. And then much later, after school and more studies and whatever, I went in for a teacher's training course. But even then I wasn't happy because I couldn't imagine myself sitting in a classroom with 50 and 60 children and just, you know, taking care of a government syllabus or something. So I went around looking for something different. I went to many institutes, and when I went to this one particular place, the principal was teaching four deaf children, and she was teaching them to listen, and they were responding. And it just took me a few minutes to decide that this is what I wanted to do. So then I enrolled myself in a training course, and that's it, started teaching. I said after doing my teacher's training, I went round to several institutes to see what I really wanted to do. And I came across this one place which was for hearing impaired children. The principal was teaching and I watched her. And it took me just a few minutes to decide that this is what I wanted to do. So then I enrolled for a course, which was a year for a year, and started teaching.
Right, great ma'am. Ma'am, your organization, ORED.
Yes.
Or is that how it's pronounced, ORED, or am I getting it wrong?
You're right.
Right, ORED. So what do you guys do, and how does the technology that you built, that you have a patent in the US, how does it work exactly?
Okay. ORED stands for oral education, oral meaning listening. So we teach children to listen and speak, and they can actually speak like you and me. There is this, you know, people, parents keep saying that they're looking for a miracle for their child to be able to be normal. Actually, the miracle is here because they have cochlear implants, which are implants that are implanted in the organ of hearing, and that enables them to hear all that we're saying. The difficult part is that they have to learn to process what they hear. And that's where our therapy comes in. So we teach on a one-to-one, and every child is on a different level, but eventually they do learn to listen and speak.
Right, great ma'am. There's this one, yes, please continue.
No, it was really in about 1985 that I learned about audit verbal therapy, because there was a professional who came from Australia, Alan Kelly, and he continued coming for the next 6, 7 years. And after the first year, I started ORED so that I could try with something new. And he used to come in and mentor me in this method. And that's how ORED started and was the first of its kind in India.
Right, fantastic, ma'am. There's actually one thing I would like to touch upon is the misconception among people, among the general masses, जो कि जब हम बोलते हैं कि ये थोड़ा बहरा है, जो कि लोग सुनने में आते हैं कि जनरलाइज करके बोल देते हैं कि ये बहरा है, बट देन लाइक आई सेड बिफोर, हियरिंग इम्पेयरमेंट के अलग अलग सीवियरिटी होते हैं। एक बड़ा मिसकंसेप्शन है, आई गेस यू नो टू ए लेवल की एक क्राइम माना जा सकता है, मी पर्सनली मैं बहुत बता रहा हूँ कि जब आप हियरिंग इम्पेयर बताते हो, यूजुअली लोग बोलते हैं कि अच्छा डेफ एंड डम, यू ऑटोमेटिकली अटैच दिस पर्टिकुलर लेबल की मतलब राइमिंग में लग रहा है कि डेफ एंड डम, तो पीपल अटैच कर लेते हैं। सो मैम, बैक इन 1970s और 1984 एज यू सेड, व्हेन यू
यस
स्टार्टेड वर्किंग विथ योर प्रोग्राम एंड योर इंस्टीट्यूशन, तो वॉट काइंड ऑफ सोसाइटल मिसकंसेप्शंस और टबूज यू हैड टू फेस टू एक्चुअली स्टैंड अप एंड यू नो टू टैकल दिस सिचुएशन इन रियल लाइफ इन द पब्लिक?
Well, you know, by that time, people had begun to realize that deaf and dumb don't go together. Because you can be dumb, but you can hear. And you can be deaf and you can speak. So, yes, there were a few pockets which believed that, but I think that terminology is gone by now. Anything?
ऑडियंस इंटरेक्शन बहुत ही है, आई मीन देर लाइक सो मैनी कॉमेंट्स, मैं अभी एक एक करके नाम बुलाऊंगा, द अदर पर्सन विल फील लाइक उनका नाम नहीं ले रहा हूँ मैं। देर सो मैनी टेंस ऑफ कॉमेंट्स एंड 40+ पीपल वॉचिंग। सो गाइज, आपकी कोई भी क्वेश्चन होंगे, आपकी कोई भी जानकारी आपको जानना है, आई गेस अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल आर इंटरेस्टेड इन वॉचिंग यू, दे केम बिकॉज यू प्रोबेबली शेयर इट एंड सो ऑन। लेकिन गाइज, आई हैव ऑल्सो इन्वाइटेड यू नो मेरे ओल्ड स्पेशल एजुकेशन क्लासमेट्स फ्रॉम कॉलेज, माई फैकल्टी, एंड आस्क देम टू, आस्क नहीं, डिमांड किया मैंने कि शेयर कीजिए। यू नो अजीज़ा मैम, येस्टरडे वी वर हैविंग दिस कॉन्वर्जेशन, मैम बता रही थी कि लाइक शी एब्सोल्युटली हेट्स कंप्यूटर्स और कैमराज और माइक्स एंड ऑल। सो वन थिंग इज़ आई एम वेरी थैंकफुल दैट शी इज़ हियर विद अस टुडे। थोड़ा स्केप्टिकल है मैम भी, बट वी आर सो थैंकफुल टू हैव हर विद अस। फर्स्टली आई टेक अ क्वेश्चन, ऑडियंस का एक क्वेश्चन आया है फ्रॉम विश्वजीत दिलीप। हाय अजीज़ा, सो गुड टू सी यू। वन क्वेश्चन आई हैव, इफ अ पेरेंट फाइंड्स आउट दैट देयर चाइल्ड इज हियरिंग इम्पेयर इन इंडिया, व्हाट शुड बी द कोर्स ऑफ एक्शन? अ लॉट ऑफ पेरेंट्स फील दैट देयर चाइल्ड्स फ्यूचर इज कॉम्प्रोमाइज कंप्राइज एंड दे टेंड टू गो इन टू अ डिप्रेशन।
See, going into depression, anxiety, depression, and all is very normal. And I think all parents, after the diagnosis, do go into a cycle of maybe blaming themselves or being angry about it, or they're indifferent, they withdraw. But slowly they do come out of it if they're given proper guidance. Because what we have to convince the parents that today being having a child with a hearing loss is not such a big deal. Because they will learn to listen, they will learn to speak. The only thing is that the parents have to be totally involved. It's a parent-oriented program. They have to be equal partners. Actually, they have to be the primary caretaker.
गाइस, थोड़ी सी नेटवर्क इशू आ रही है, प्लीज बेयर विद अस। हाँ
They are all there to support them. I mean, new technology has enabled that, you know, deaf children to listen, to speak, to participate, to be part of a society where they're contributing members, and that's what we have to convince them about.
Right. If there are any parents watching, or you know, anyone who's at that age, Jape, you have a circle of parents around you, or any teachers also, please do, you know, spread awareness and educate your colleagues and your fellows, as in ye parent oriented hona chahiye. You know, the parent needs to be educated themselves firstly, to, you know, for even at least reach out to people who are educated in this. You know, at least wo initiative ya motive aa jaye, to I think that's very important. Guys, aapke question send karte rahiye. We'll just get to that in a minute. Firstly, I'll go to Mr. Sen. Over to you.
Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the show. Aziza ma'am, welcome to the show. It's wonderful to have you with us and sharing your story and your journey of working with people, young people, making lives, changing lives, and making a difference to so many lives. Because if you change one life, you're actually changing 10, 12, 15 lives through that one life. Now, one of the things that happens in society is whenever we have such problems, there is a problem of, you know, a societal shame or something. How is that being dealt with? I mean, if I could make myself understood.
I think the important thing is to be able to counsel the parents correctly, because it starts there. And they want to cover up, you know, a handicap that the child has. And it's not really a handicap. So we have to teach them to be open about it, to talk about it with friends, ask them to help in the whole process, because people need to communicate with the child. And like we have this wonderful parent, I'm talking about many years ago, about 20 years ago. And our parents used to cover, there were no cochlear implants at that time. And they used to cover up the hearing aids by growing the hair long, you know, boys, girls, both, they used to cover them. And this parent bought covers for her child's hearing aids, which could be bought in every color under the sun. And he used to wear those and match them with his clothes. And slowly the trend caught on, and other parents do it as well, you know, and realized there's nothing wrong in being or having a hearing loss, as normal as you and me. So really it is that we have to deal with, that parents should not be ashamed of it.
Yeah. And if you compared it to the Western world, is the acceptance of such conditions acceptable in the West more than it is in India? What is the difference?
That's a good question. Actually, I can only tell you from what we hear and what we see about the Western world. And again, they take a lot of time to counsel people and counsel their communities. We also go to the children's school. They're all integrated into regular schools, and we do visit the schools and talk to the children, talk to the teachers, so that it becomes something that everyone accepts. But I think it happens a little more easily in the West, because we have a lot of other problems as well, like in the villages. If a child can't speak and he makes odd noises, he'll just be put down as mentally retarded.
Yeah.
You know? So really it's educating the people that is required.
And I think that's the biggest challenge that we have in front of us. Because at the moment you're different in whatever way, there is a tendency of being, you know, sort of labeled as something.
Yes.
And so what would you say is the best way to educate the masses? Because the parents is one thing, and that I think you have covered. But then there is a society at large, relatives, the broader relatives, it goes out the ring. And you know, therein comes more problems and more complexities that come in. So how is that being tackled?
You know, I think one of the ways that we could do it is expose the children a little more who have, I mean, there are hundreds who are able to listen and speak, and let them be part of dramas and talks, and let them talk about themselves and tell the public what they're able to do, what they have achieved. Because if they see it for themselves, they will believe it. Just by us talking about it is not going to be enough.
Right.
So I think that we need to be exposed much more.
So I think what you're saying is we need to create role models who can stand up and deliver the message to the rest of the world so that they can understand and say that, okay, it's a perfectly normal thing. It's nothing to be afraid of, nothing to put a label on, and move forward in life.
Believe me, you don't even have to look for role models. You'll be amazed at the number of children who can speak like you and me, and you can question them about their experiences and things, and that is enough to convince people that they are normal.
I have a slightly different question on the same topic, but you know, music or singing is usually said to be, you can read music and play. That's one way, that's the Western style. But in India, the way music is taught is through the ear.
Yes.
When people hear the music and then they play around with it. What is your experience of such young people who are learning music?
You mean children with hearing loss?
Yes.
Yes. So we expose them to music right from the beginning, because if you say, I mean, I did explain that the cochlear implant enables them to listen to frequencies across the range. And so music is a very important part of their education. Yeah. Because music is not just for the sake of a tune, but it helps in developing good speech in many, many ways. I mean, there's rhythm, there's pausing, there's pitch, there's all kinds of things. And they do respond. I mean, we have special music classes, special music teachers. And they can do learn to appreciate it. You'll find many hearing impaired children listening to music all day.
And this, I think, is really extraordinary that, you know, what the general people think is hearing impaired, you cannot sing, you cannot get into music, you cannot get into the arts. So, you know, there is the other thing as a human being, which we urge, long for, is a sense of, is a medium of expression. And music, art, drama, these are all art forms of expression. And what you're saying is, yes, that freedom of expressing oneself can be given to the child.
Yes, we have a child who's actually composing music.
Wow. Would you like to share that story for the audience and everyone? And ma'am, if I may request you, I'm sure Aditya is smiling because we know that there are a lot of people who are not so comfortable with English. So perhaps in Hindi, so that, you know, some people will benefit perhaps.
You want to know about this child who composes music? He does it as a hobby. And I'm afraid you'll have to translate what I say.
Okay, no problem. Just go ahead.
It's just that he came to us when he was a baby. I mean, he was a year and something when he came to us and started with this auditory verbal therapy. There were no cochlear implants at that time. He learned to listen and speak. And he had a progressive hearing loss. So it started going down. And then at the age of 7 or 8, we had him implanted. He was, and He listens beautifully. He speaks beautifully. He's graduated from Elphinstone College. He's done his design. He's amazing. And in his free time, he likes to compose music. So
that's really inspiring. That is really inspiring indeed.
We've got children who are super architects. We've got chartered accountants working in banks. A whole lot of, like any other teenager or youngster.
Let me ask Samad, what is the audience saying? And I'm sure the audience must be having scores of questions for you. So let's go back to the audience.
Mr. Sen, today, mujhe galat mat manna, lekin I was waiting
for you to end. Today is your day. Samad, it's your day.
Now, I was waiting for you to, you know, finish up with your questions, kyunki bahut interactive hai, audience. The chat is extremely like, kuch zyada interactive hai. No, I appreciate all the comments and questions. I guess, firstly, you know, ek ek karke jaate hain. That's the easiest way to deal with this. Firstly, Shweta Patalia Jhaveri, who says, I wish you could see our children doing music. Definitely. Ma'am, is your organization in Mumbai currently? Or
yes.
It's
at Mahalakshmi, near our famous studio.
Great. So next time we visit Mumbai, Pro Bono visits Mumbai, definitely, I ensure you, we'll visit Ored and we'll make a vlog. With ma'am's permission, of course, and you guys will you keep you guys updated, and that would be great. And also we have a few comments. Let me see. Yep, Shweta ji also says Aziza has done commendable work in the field and is making huge difference in the lives of hearing impaired children, and importantly mainstreaming them. Right, and also let me see. Riyan Jhaveri asks, what is your message for the youth of today who want to make a difference in the society and help the lesser privileged?
And help
the lesser privileged.
Well, I think I know Riyan, and he and his sister already are making a difference in the lives of underprivileged children. His sister had done some programs at ORED. She helped to collect funds. She made people more aware of the needs, financial and otherwise. And Riyan too. They are good examples. They should talk more to their friends, because their mother is a therapist at ORED, and they can get enough information about it and encourage their friends and other young people to get more involved as volunteers.
Right, so Shweta and Riyan, they're already doing fantastic work. So I guess what you need to do is not take more motivation, give us all motivation to help other people, you know, to help the children with hearing impairment, mainstream them, and I hope special needs children in general. Ma'am,
I didn't hear your last sentence.
I said Riyan and Shweta, they're already doing such fantastic work. I think unko motivation ki zarurat nahi hai. They need to motivate us all. They need to motivate the people that are in the chat around them, taki, you know, we can mainstream children with hearing loss and special needs kids in general. And, you know, make this whole thing mainstream, make the kids mainstream and make them independent. There was actually a comment by Himanshu Bose, who is Aditya's father. He shared a small anecdote. Good evening, ma'am. We also went through the trauma when Aditya couldn't communicate till the age of 4. We had consulted speech therapists, renowned ENT specialists, and finally clinical psychologists. Finally, he started talking after consulting Dr. Aruna Brutra and her guidance, and then he developed to a talkative boy. And now finally, he is a public speaker. So there's a bounce back story going back to 2 days back. Ma'am, actually, there was one question when you said, you know, trying to bring them to a mainstream platform, trying to, you know, provide them that which they're lacking so that they can build themselves. So one thing, how do you or your organization, how do you focus on morale building rather than, you know, the giving them implants or any kind of tech to build their speech skills? How do you build their morale? How do you go about facing that issue?
I tell you something, mainstreaming these children is not a big deal anymore, because once they start listening and they're able to communicate, you don't want them to go into a special school where they learn very limited stuff. They go in with regular hearing children, and you don't have to build their morale. They're just like any other child in the classroom. And if they have special problems, they still come to us for therapy and we discuss it and deal with it at that point of time. Right. So every center now that has children with cochlear implants is mainstreaming their children.
Great, fantastic, ma'am. Guys, agar main clear kar do for anyone in the audience who's not familiar with the terminology, special school jo hota hai, as we see normal schools jo hum log hamare bacche jaate hi hai, and special school is where there are completely special needs kids. Unka curriculum is designed specifically for that individual, not a class, but that individual. And there are different training methods incorporated, what we call special educators, and there are audiologists, there are physiotherapists, और बहुत सारे फैसिलिटीज़ और बहुत सारे रिहैब सेंटर क्रिएट करते हैं. सो दैट इज जस्ट द पॉइंट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन. लेट मी सी, देयर बहुत से इतने सारे क्वेश्चन आई एम ट्राइंग टू फिल्टर आउट. गाइस, मुझे विलेन मत मानना अगर मैं आपका क्वेश्चन मिस आउट कर दिया. देयर वाज अ क्वेश्चन, देयर इज अ क्वेश्चन बाय विश्वजीत दिलीप, हु आस्क्ड व्हाट काइंड ऑफ करियर ऑप्शंस आर देयर इन द फील्ड ऑफ ओरल एजुकेशन.
विश्वजीत, There is no limit. Whatever careers are available for hearing children are available for these children as well. As I told you, that we've got children who are architects and designers and chartered accountants, even teachers. So there's nothing specific for children with hearing loss. They can do anything except maybe be a music conductor or something. But
great. Before I go to the next question, there was this is not exactly a question, but aapke liye, I guess I would say an experience in my life. Back in college, conferences hote rehte. To a certain point, CRE credit ke liye hote hai for RCA license. But then there was a particular suggestion by a MA graduate. Unhone bola hai ki you don't need to, you know, revolutionize the whole education system. You know, you don't need to alag se, you know, rallies conduct karne ki zarurat nahi hai. What to mainstream these children for the future? Bahut hi simple sa suggestion diya tha unhone. Have 2 to 3 chapters primary school mein in your within our textbook itself. CBSE ka curriculum hi maan lete, for example, aapko mushkil se mushkil 2 se 3 chapter lagana hai, so that bachpan se hi hum is field ko, you know, normalize kare ya fir isko awareness leke aaye bachcho ke liye. Ma'am, what would you know, how would you respond to this particular suggestion or idea?
See, it is very important for the public to know what the possibilities are and to sensitize them in accepting children with hearing loss. We have teacher trainees who come in just for observation. They are teaching regular hearing children. They come in to be sensitized to children with hearing loss. And that's great, because this training college sends their teachers every year so that they learn how to handle problems when they come across them. I think this chapter thing, nobody will pay attention to. I think that when we integrate a child, we should take the trouble of visiting the school and talking to the teachers, talking to other parents of hearing children, because we've also had complaints from parents saying that my child is imitating the deaf child's speech. You know, so those kind of things need to be dealt with. And we have to really sensitize the students apart from the teachers.
Right, great. And I always believed in this, you know, special educator ko hi nahi, or the audiologist or a speech therapist ko hi nahi. Every teacher should get all round, you know, certain bit of training as to kaise in bachcho ke saath deal karte ho. Or at least they should have a basic foundational, you know, training ki kaise inko, how you go about, you know, at least treating these children, or how do you manage the environment around them. So I guess like Aziza ma'am said, definitely goes. yeah, we have a few comments as well. Aditya Ashbura mat manna, I know you have a lot of questions dimag mein chal raha hai because you're thoda new hai field tumhare liye, but I'll get to you in a minute. Vajayanti ji says, it is a privilege to work with Aziza. We have learned a lot from her. Also during this lockdown period, she is taking utmost efforts to enhance our knowledge. That's very fantastic to hear. That's very great to hear. We have a few more questions. Abhijit Di, I'll address your question. Abhijit Ghosh asks, you guys do a great program, but few of us may not be able, may not be always in a position in real time and happen to watch the recording later on. If you have a question pertaining to a certain discussion while watching the recording, how do we get the answer? Abhijit ji and everyone who would probably watch this recording later on, aap hame private message laga sakte ho on Facebook or on Instagram, koi bhi social media hai, do connect with us and we'll forward your question with the specific guest. Jaise aaj Aziza ma'am hai, we'll forward the question to her aur unke shabdon mein answer, we'll try our best to, you know, answer your question through her. So bilkul aap hame private message laga sakte ho. Let's see, Anita ji ka question hai, what are the challenges kids with hearing loss face while making their career like normal kids? Means, what's the rate of recovery for kids? Is it different for different kids depending on the stages of hearing loss?
Yeah, it is different for different kids because a lot of things come into consideration over here. The background of the child, the, you know, financial background, what opportunities are given to the child. I mean, also their experiences, what they're exposed to in their lives. It's obvious that some will have more of this than others, and it makes it easier then for them to choose a career. Have more experiences.
Ma'am, could you please repeat the last... Ha, ma'am, there was a network issue. Could you please repeat the last maybe half a minute?
Okay, can you just repeat the question?
Yeah, just a second. Let's see. Sorry, comments itne hai. Yes, what are the challenges kids with hearing loss face while making their career like normal kids? Means, what's the rate of recovery for the kids? Is it different for different kids depending on the stages of hearing loss?
Yeah, there are two, three things all bundled into one over there. There's no such thing as recovery. It depends on the age of the child, when he was diagnosed, when the therapy starts, at what age the cochlear implant is done, and whether the parents are regular in their therapy or not, and whether they're doing their work at home. That all, if their success, the child's success really depends on the family and the parents, and of course good advice and a good therapist. So what they achieve depends on all these things. So depending on what they achieve, they will go in for a job that they're capable of doing.
Thank you, ma'am. We have a comment from Vaijayanti ji. No, actually, I already covered that. Sorry, my bad. Let's see. There's a question by Hatake Kakashi. If I'm pronouncing that wrong, mat karna mujhe. Ma'am, my kid with cochlear implant has just finished pre-KG. I am worried whether he would be able to get admitted to a regular school post-lockdown. As I hear, regular schools are averse to admitting special kids. Could you advise special schools which welcome kids with special needs?
Actually, I'm afraid I don't know too much about special schools, and I wouldn't advise it unless I knew that the child was incapable of coping in a regular school. I mean, has the child been implanted? Did you say he's had a cochlear implant?
Yeah, my kid with cochlear implant has just finished pre-KG.
If he goes into a special school, he's going to be exposed to a lot of incorrect speech and language, because he is in a special school where children have not been taught to listen and speak. So what's the purpose of a cochlear implant if you want to then push him back into a special school? The cochlear implant enables a child to develop like any hearing child. And they can do the therapy and teaching at home. He's only in KG just now. So it doesn't matter if a school doesn't accept him just now. He can do a lot of training in the house, but he needs guidance from a therapist.
Ma'am, if I can just add a little bit point of information. Kakashi ji, agar koi bhi school if a regular school is denying your admission for your child on the basis of his disability or on the basis of him having implant, agar aapke bacche ka, if he is qualified to get an admission just as a normal regular child would, so if they deny you admission on the basis of the disability, it's a violation of human rights. The law has been laid down by CBSE, and you can refer the particular IDEA Act, IDEA, IDEA Act, Individuals with Disability Education Act. So you can file a case at Human Rights Commission, and bilkul aapko dena hi padega, unko aapke bachche ko admission dena hi padega. And jaise ki maine bataya, aapke bachche agar admission ka qualification agar hai, to milna hi chahiye. Disability ke basis pe aapko deny nahi kar sakte. Just a point of information there. Let's see. Guys, thank you so much for your interaction. मुझे ये मत मानना कि बहुत सारे क्वेश्चन आ रहे हैं तो मैं थोड़ा कुछ ज़्यादा घबरा रहा हूँ, लेकिन I absolutely love the interaction, सारे comments तो one by one पढ़ने नहीं हो पाएगा, but I'll try to cover as many as possible. Let's see. कृष्णा जी का question है, कृष्णा वाल्मीकि, not our regular viewer कृष्णा. थोड़ा हिंदी में लिखा है तो प्लीज़ बेयर विथ मी, थोड़ा मेरा हिंदी तबलेम. ऑरेट के सब टीचर खुद ही अच्छे हैं, बच्चों के साथ साथ पेरेंट्स को भी सिखाते हैं कि उनको बच्चों के साथ साथ क्या करना चाहिए, उनको कैसे हैंडल करना चाहिए. I fully did not understand the question. Aditya, if you did understand the question.
Sure, I'll give it a shot to read it out. I'll find the comment. Till then, if I can ask one question, Samant, am I allowed?
Yeah, just one more audience question, and then you can, probably get back to that.
Sure.
Let's see. Bahut sare compliments or comments are. There was a question by Bina Himanshu who asked, which is the best institute to get training for special education? I guess जैसे कि मैम अभी बताए थे कि she is not going to give out names, she is not into that, तो time waste नहीं करते हैं उस पर. बहुत सारे I'm trying to cover as many questions as possible. Okay, Aditya, over to you, I guess.
Right, so first I'll read that comment which was posted because Kumud ji might be waiting. Krishna ji might be waiting. So I'll read it out. ORED के सब teacher बहुत ही अच्छे हैं, बच्चों के साथ साथ parents को भी सिखाते हैं कि उनको बच्चों के साथ क्या क्या करना चाहिए और उनको कैसे हैंडल करना चाहिए. सो इट्स अ कॉम्प्लीमेंट टू यू एंड योर वर्क अजीजा मैम, लाइक दे रियली कॉम्प्लीमेंट द वे यू टीच नॉट ओनली द स्टूडेंट्स बट द पेरेंट्स ऑल्सो, लाइक वॉट ऑल टू डू इन दिस सिचुएशन एंड हाउ टू take it forward. Shanti Chalappa asks, does ORED have branches?
Yes, we have a satellite center in Hyderabad. And we have an affiliate center in Nairobi as well.
Great. So, Shanti, I hope you got your answer. Mrs. Lata Dilip, who is Vishwajit's mother, she asks, Aured's mobile screening program was also started by Aziza to screen children for hearing loss from underprivileged families in the slums in and around Mumbai. So I think that's a great compliment again for Aziza, ma'am. And I think the work that she has done really...
Aditya, why this program started was I was worried about children being labeled in school.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, the minute you find a child who's a little slow or not responding, he's put down as either stupid or mentally challenged or something, where it could just be a mild hearing loss.
Mm-hmm.
And the second thing is, it also works as prevention of hearing loss, because there are a lot of these children from underprivileged homes who have ear infections. And if that is neglected, then it becomes a permanent hearing loss without being attended to by a doctor.
Very true. Right. So you hit it at a time when you saw that you can solve a problem.
Well, at least we could identify children and deal with it. I mean, we screen about 3,000 children a year from slum areas. And I don't know what's going to happen now, because a lot of them were migrant worker children.
And that's an issue to be thought about. I hope we can do something together to solve this. And obviously, Aziza ma'am, the great work that she's doing, hopefully, you know, all of us in the audience and us who are here can hopefully, you know, in our small capacity, join on in the movement and do something about this. Vishwajit asks, would career guidance be helpful for children with hearing impairment and their parents? Maybe a special career guidance module so that parents don't feel that their children have limited opportunities. The ex-students of Aured could be the mentors for the future generations. And what's your take on that?
Vishwajit, I would say that, yes, career guidance is very important, but for any youngster. Why especially for children with hearing impairment?
Right. Yes, ma'am. So I think... And since we are career guides, so I can also say that everybody is supposed to have a career. And it's a valid question that Vishwajit asks. I think it's kind of, you know, giving us the lens of society, basically, that what society can ask us. So, I think we can provide career guidance to anyone, whether that be, you know, because see, I also have specs. But since I, you know, this is something which is normalized, I think all four of us are wearing specs. So since this is normalized, I think, you know, we don't really care much about it. But when we talk about something like a hearing impairment or a bigger, you know, visual impairment, that is when doubts start to be get raised. And as Aziza ma'am, you know, was saying initially that, you know, somebody made a fashion statement out of it by getting matching colors. It's just about that. So like, you know, we wear different color specs. If we can make a fashion statement out of it, it is pretty much normal, like any other thing.
Oh, and also when, I mean, we tell the children that we can't see properly, so we wear specs. You can't hear properly, you wear hearing aids or you have a cochlear implant. I mean, one has to be matter of fact about it, not make issue out of it. And a lot to do with the parents, their attitude, the family members.
Right. Ma'am, what are the careers in oral education? So let's say, you know, if you want more Aureds to be in, kind of, you know, established around India, what kind of an education should we be getting or should students aim for if they want to join you in this movement or in this field?
Well, there are several courses. After, there are BEds for hearing impairment at Ali Avarjung. And after that, there is a short course in auditory verbal therapy. So that could be done. They do their graduation in special education and then do an additional course in auditory verbal therapy. That is the ideal thing.
Got it. So there are courses, guys. And as Aziza ma'am told, you know, the way Samanth, our very own Samanth, has done a BEd in special education, you can do a BEd in specifically you know, oral education related fields, hearing impairment, how to solve for that, and you can move forward.
And even audiologists, if they want to continue with their career in just audiology, that also, there's a whole section that is only for children with cochlear implants. because there is audiological management, which is known as mapping. And that's like tracking the progress of a child and seeing that his device is in working order. And that has to be taken care of by very specially trained audiologists.
So ma'am, for audiologists, I'm pretty sure that they need to study biology also, like in school.
No, I don't think so.
Achha, it's not necessary,
but,
right?
No, but why should they learn about the rest of the body?
Got it. So can they do it from arts and commerce also?
You mean audiology?
Yeah.
Arts and commerce. I'm not very sure. I don't.
No, actually, just to, you know, as Aditya mentioned, can you become an audiologist after pursuing arts or commerce? A teacher of mine from college.
Sorry.
Yeah, a teacher of mine, he has studied history and he's done his arts, I think. But he's pursued to become a specialist teacher and an audiologist.
Wow.
So possible hai, it's not impossible. बस थोड़ा मुश्किल तो रहेगा ऑब्वियसली जैसे वी से व्हेन यू स्विच स्ट्रीम्स थोड़ा तो प्रॉब्लम रहेगा ही बट इट्स नथिंग इम्पॉसिबल
यू मस्ट हैव हैड टू गो थ्रू द होल कोर्स इन ऑडियोलॉजी एंड स्पीच थेरेपी
या मैम डेफिनेटली
स्टडी इट
राइट यू हैड टू गो थ्रू दैट एंड वी एक्चुअली एंजॉयड हिज क्लासेस अ लॉट टू से द लीस्ट ओवर टू आदित्य आई गेस वी कैन हैव वन मोर क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम योर साइड
Got it. And,
maybe two.
Okay, thank you so much, Sam, for allowing me the quota because I'm really excited to ask Aziza ma'am all the questions. Ma'am, I would go back to again, you know, your kind of career choice, so as to say, because I really want to understand the highlights of the journey. So when you made this career choice, what was your discussion with your parents back then? Like, what did your parents say regarding your career choice? Did they motivate you? Were they a bit skeptical?
No, they weren't skeptical at all because luckily I never had that kind of problem with my parents. Mm-hmm. And they were happy as long as I was convinced that it was the right choice for me. Mm-hmm. And that's what I wanted to do. There was no resistance from my parents. I was excited about the whole thing because I thought it was fantastic that a child who is deaf using hearing aids could be taught to speak, even in the days when there were no cochlear implants.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And you know, when we started with auditory verbal therapy, mm-hmm. which was many years after I taught deaf children for many years, when we learned, we had this new batch and we weren't sure whether we were really getting anywhere because we'd never seen the end results of anything. And then we had this little girl who came up to me who we'd been training for 2 years and she could repeat everything like a parrot through audition. But there was nothing coming spontaneously from her.
Mm-hmm.
And I had a friend sitting there and, this girl came and started talking to me and a friend walked in. So I turned mm-hmm. to the friend
mm-hmm.
and she started interrupting this little girl. So I told her, I said, shut up now, just wait. So then I heard, you shut up, I was first. So I knew that the method was working because that was spontaneous. You know, that's what had happened at that time. The friend was shocked that she said, shut up to me. But that was the most exciting part of realizing that this method works.
Wow. That is so amazing. So ma'am, also, whenever we choose a career, so obviously we see the, you know, and we promote students, whoever is having a look at this and whoever is watching this podcast, we always motivate people to explore and discover their passion and then pursue them. So obviously the passion is a very important part of career, but so is also the external factors of it to an extent, like, you know, the money you get or the lifestyle that you have. So ma'am, is it a myth if I would say that there is less money in oral education or there is you know, no money?
No, that's not right, because it depends with what whether I established a charitable trust because I wanted underprivileged children to have the same facilities as the privileged ones. But if you just work in a center that is commercial like any other school, you earn like any other teacher. I mean, and maybe more.
Got it, ma'am.
As a special educator, you can.
So you hear, guys, from the expert herself, there's no, real money issues in this field.
It depends on how good you are and how committed you are, because you have to show results.
True.
Then people will be willing to pay.
Right.
Guys, actually, अगर एक स्टैटिस्टिक लगा दो जस्ट टू यू नो अगर थोड़े बहुत किसी को इस फील्ड में थोड़ा बहुत इंटरेस्ट है लेकिन मनी का लग रहा है ये लेट मी थ्रो यू अ फाइनेंशियल प्रोपोजिशन DSSSB दिल्ली स्टाफ सिलेक्शन एग्जाम पूरा फुल फॉर्म याद नहीं है बट फॉर दिल्ली गवर्नमेंट स्कूल्स स्पेशल एजुकेटर का सैलरी रेंजेस फ्रॉम 35,000 to 55,000 फॉर अ फ्रेशर तो आपको सीटेट क्लियर करना होगा और DSSSB का जो भी बेसिक क्वालिफिकेशन से एग्जाम होगा वो क्लियर करना पड़ेगा सो इनफैक्ट गवर्नमेंट स्कूल्स में यू एक्चुअली हैव मोर मनी देन एनी अदर टीचर सो अगर पैसे माइंडेड मनी माइंडेड थोड़े हैं लेकिन हिचकिचा रहे हैं सो दैट्स अ मोटिव फॉर यू जस्ट अनदर पॉइंट ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेशन यस मैम यू वॉज
Sorry, are you waiting for me to say something? I said, first of all, I must tell all my teachers to shut their ears when you give those kind of figures because they're never going to reach there. And government-trained teachers do not have the same kind of training that's required for this kind of method. And that's one of the reasons that I never wanted, from the social welfare, any teachers from there, because they earn big money, but they're not able to do what they're supposed to. And yet you have to keep them and pay them that salary.
Right, obviously the first motivating factor has to be passion to work in this field. And preferably the only motivating factor.
And you have to understand the field and know what you're trying to achieve. If you just want to achieve sitting in a classroom with 10 children and teaching, if you can call that teaching, that's fine. If you want to see the child developing his listening skills, learning to communicate through spoken language, then you have to go through special training. And if you work in a place like ORED, you'll never get a big salary. Most of our children are from underprivileged homes, so...
If I may respond to this, Aziza ma'am, I think the biggest payment or the biggest gratification is when that child goes on and achieves something in life.
Of course.
And you feel so proud that you were part of that.
Well, you're right. That is what makes us keep going.
And I don't think any amount of money can replace that.
Very true.
Great. I guess I think we are close to 1 hour. Mr. Sen, if you have one question, but just one question before we wrap this up.
Right. Ma'am, it has been a privilege and an honor to have been talking to you and hearing from you throughout the evening. And I always wondered, what is the definition of a legend? Today, I got the opportunity to speak to one. Thank you very much, ma'am.
Thank you.
Okay, Mr. Sen, you actually don't have a question.
I don't have a question, no.
Okay, no problem. Let me read out a few comments and then I guess it's a good note to end on. Let me see. Firstly, we have Zoha Ali who says, my child has finished nursery and we have already secured admission in a good school. That's great to hear. Kakashi says, thank you very much Probano and Aziza ji for the information. You're most welcome. Susanna says, very informative about the Idea Act. Anita ji says, praise for Aurat it was. Okay, I think that was when I couldn't understand Hindi. Anju Dubey ma'am says, thank you Pro Bono for organizing such a nice session. Aziza ma'am, you are a great inspiration for society. By the way guys, Anju Dubey ma'am is my Hindi teacher from 10th grade. Aaj ma'am se conversation hua tab after a long time. She's actually one of the inspirations for me to become a teacher. So just trying to show my appreciation to ma'am while I have the platform here. Yes, Vaijayanti ji says, this job gives immense satisfaction. True, having worked in this field as well, you know, the satisfaction you get when you are able to actually help the child and he starts showing progress. I think, like say, Mr. Sen said, you know, that's a greater reward than any other. And we have Susanna's message again. Aziza ma'am and all teachers in Aurat are totally dedicated to teach and get our children to hear and talk and soar to greater heights. Thank you so much ma'am for informative session. At Aurat we all therapists work as a team. We are like a close-knit family. Each of us is passionate about Aurat and all children and their parents who come there. It is an idea example of how one person's passion has caught on. Thank you Aziza for all that you have done for us. This was by Kumud Misra. And this particular word, you know, close-knit family, it goes back to Akash Singh's podcast, Jape, when your team is your family, then you can absolutely achieve wonders and beyond. And finally, ma'am, I guess we wrap karna padega, unfortunately. Otherwise, we could have this conversation for longer. But ma'am, thank you so much for being with us. Any closing words? And as Anita ji puts it, any message for the society? Over to you.
Thank you for having me on your program. I hope there'll be a lot of young people who will decide to go into this field because it's really needed. And it's a very exciting field. It's never dull because there are new things coming up all the time. And if you are comfortable adapting to change for the better, then this is the perfect field to be in.
Great. Fantastic, ma'am. Again, thank you so much for taking time to be with us. As I hear from one comment, jo abhi miss out kar diya tha, it was bahut upar chale gaya hai. Aurat is still working from their home. The therapists are still working on providing sessions to the students, as one comment says. So thank you for taking time. Firstly, the audience, aapka interaction, this was definitely the best podcast. I don't know, I don't want to put down the other guests or the podcast, lekin definitely mujhe to sab bahut maza aaya and bahut seekhne ko mila, more importantly. Guys, thank you for your questions, your comments and your insights, the audience. Aditya and Mr. Sen, thank you for your contribution, your questions as well. And ma'am, thank you so much for being with us and, you know, taking time to talk with our audience, you know, answering their questions and queries. And I do hope, you know, maybe try karte rahunga to inspire more people to get into this particular field. You know, we do need to bring this forward into the society as a whole. So thank you, ma'am. Thank you for being with us. So guys, with that, thank you for being with us. See you tomorrow. Stay home. Stay indoors, wash your hands, stay safe, and we'll meet you same time tomorrow on Facebook Live at 6 PM with a different guest. And like kijiye page ko, follow us and turn on post notifications to get notified when we do go live. And we'll see you tomorrow. Take care. Bye-bye.